Welcome back to New York Comic Con Live, the final day, but you're in for a treat.
Oh, final day.
Presented by Courtyard, by the way.
Nice.
Soma and I are here.
That was the most innocuous,
I love this
smooth
dude.
Plug ever.
it doesn't stop there. It doesn't stop there.
It just gets better with this guy.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
So Soma and I are here with the legendary Troy Baker.
Wow, legendary.
Yeah. For the two of you out there that don't know who he is, he's done the voices of Joker and Batman. Talion in Shadow of Mordor.
Yes.
Awesome.
Joel in Last of Us.
Thank
you.
Holy crap.
Yeah,
that's so
just
cool.
It's just like basically any the games you play, this man's the magical voice in it.
Aww.
But we're here to talk about not just you, but
you can
also
do it.
Yes.
Well, hold on, really fast. I just got to tell you.
What?
There's only two pieces of media that ever made me cry. A film called Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants. And I'm not even kidding.
Really?
Yeah. That's a couple sad parts. Blake Lively made me cry.
All right.
And then your character and what he does in The Last of Us.
Oh, man.
I'm not going to say anything about it, but I leaked a little bit.
Yeah, if it's spoilers at this point, I don't know.
Dude, there's someone out there that doesn't know about what happened.
Yeah, they deserve to be
spoiled. Give this game a shot. I really haven't heard a lot about it, but I'll give it a whirl.
That's what your character's voice sounds like, right?
Yeah, you're supposed to originally kind of be from that Massachusetts area. But
it's terrible.
Well, you could go up north to North Dakota, don't you?
Oh, absolutely. That's where the next one's going to take place. I'm joking, by the way.
The internet
explodes and we start talking.
They just confirmed The Last of Us 2. It's like Fargo. It takes place in Wisconsin.
Oof-da.
Oh, God, there.
Oh, jeepers. Anyway.
But what we're really here to talk about.
Go.
Get ready for it.
You can do
Lego it. Lego DC Superheroes Justice League Cosmic Clash.
Damn, that's
a lot. Half an hour prep right there, baby.
Holy shit, all right. It does get better.
It does.
That's a super hard title.
I know. It's
nine words.
That was the audition because there's a lot of people that want to talk to us about this. They're like, here's your test. Can you say the title? If you can, you may speak to them about it.
Don't ask me.
No, I can't do it.
But cool. Tell us about The
project.
It's a Lego like animated feature.
Yes. So here's what's great. We started off with this thing with Lego Batman 2,
right?
And which was pretty cool because it was the first time we actually ever gave a voice to Lego characters. Because before it'd always be that.
Sure.
You know? Yeah. And they let us run with it, and then of course that turned into the Lego Batman movie, not the one that's coming out, but the one that we did first. and then, of course, we've done subsequent stuff. We had the Bizarro League one that we did. We also did other games in there too. Dimensions is about to come out.
Right.
And in this one, it's kind of a cool thing because we have the auspicious ability to be able to pull from all of the Batman lore and all of the DC universe. Whereas someone, you know, they're doing this new movie about Batman versus Superman. I haven't heard anything about it.
Who's the Superman guy?
Benjamin Affleck, I believe, is playing Batman.
Sounds like a nice guy.
You know, and here you have to kind of, Ben Affleck's got to kind of make you not remember the Christian Bale movies and the Nolan movies.
Yeah, good luck.
But we get to pull from everything from the graphic novels, we get to pull from the animated series, from the Burton movies, from the Nolan movies, from all these beautiful things, and just turn them into something that's a little more palatable. We have people that have, someone brought this up in the panel today, like, how do you feel about this possibly being the first foray that someone has into these characters or these stories? I'm like, poop. that's an incredible incredible opportunity for us.
Absolutely.
So, what's the theme of this particular Cosmic Clash? Is it like?
Let's see. What can I tell you without giving too much away? We figured what we should probably do to just really mess with people's heads is do time travel.
Okay. And that's always great to just like totally throw me off. Have no idea what's going on. But you guys will do it well, I'm sure.
Well, yes. And there's some pretty important things from side universes with certain characters that we implore to actually bring in how we do time travel. But of course, this time Brainiac is going to try to shrink the world and put it
in a vial. That's
what Brainiac does.
He's a jerk.
And what's so funny is I never thought of Brainiac being as OCD as he actually is. Hello. but they with the first reveal of Brainiac, he was like making sure that all of his canisters are facing the exact same way with all the labels. I was talking to Phil about it. I was like, so basically your superpower and your weakness is your OCD.
Exactly.
It would be my undoing. How did they know? But it's great because we've got an amazing cast. Phil Lamar is Brainiac. That's a little bit of gas. I apologize.
Smells
and
great.
We have Phil Lamar as Brainiac. We have Nolan North, of course, coming back as Superman. And I get to play Batman.
Which is amazing. So my question is, this being like a Lego movie, how does that affect the tone of the movie? Like, is it like more funny? Or
absolutely. I mean, this is the beauty of Lego. And it's to me, it's got a pretty, we always talk about wanting to have a broad appeal, but this actually does have it. This is something that I've talked to five-year-olds, lengthy discussion with five-year-olds, because that's kind of my speed. Everyone up to 50-year-old. You know, I sat last Christmas and got my nephew the Batcave, and I was doing my best to put this thing together, and he was like, "You're not doing it right." And took it from me, like, put it together in 15 seconds. So obviously, we want to have there be a little bit of levity to it, which is great because we've explored a lot of the more precarious, dramatic, dark things within the Batman, especially Batman Superman arc. Batman hating Superman, there's always that, or the fact that he was very reluctant to join the Justice League. And how do we put that within the framework of Lego and make it fun?
Sure.
So there's a lot of things you don't think typically you'd be able to do, but you actually are.
Would you be willing to say something to the crowd in your voice?
In my
voice?
Your
other voice?
Hello, Batman's everyone. Voice? It's 2:50.
Don't be a jerk. throw on the bat voice.
So this is what's so fun, is everyone's like, how do you find the voice? I'm like, that's Batman to me. My Batman is me doing my best Kevin Conroy impersonation. That's pretty much how I like.
Okay.
But it's just, I'm Batman. That's my, and whenever Batman refers to himself in the first person, or in the third person rather, you know, you always have to add that gravel to it. There's one line in the trailer that you'll see, we released a new trailer for the movie today, and it says, Cyborg says, good luck. He goes, I don't believe in luck. Says, what do you believe in? Batman. That whole thing just summates who Batman is.
Oh man, so I was also curious about, like, you have the Lego movie, like, which was like a phenomenal hit, and like, you know, I thought it was just being a kid's thing, but apparently everyone, it might be another one. I don't know, who knows? But like everyone, like, you know, like fell in love with it, no matter what the age, for the most part. You know, I had that song that just can't get out of my head. Let's not bring it up. No. But like, how do you think that impacted, if anything, like, you know, like this feature that you're doing now?
You know, I think that first of all, Lego's had tremendous success, and again, it's something that is incredibly palatable to any age range, and they did a fantastic job with the movie.
Right.
I think that, you know, I'm not going to say their success we brought about. It's not predicated on what we did, but we did do it first.
You did it first. Yes.
Looking at you, Will Arnett. completely joking.
But shots.
You look at like Lego Dimensions too. Lego Dimensions has, you know, everything you can think of: Back to the Future, Wizard of Oz, Doctor Who, Scooby Doo. I'm forgetting a whole bunch of stuff that's in that. So I think that Lego is such a great entry point for people to experience things that maybe normally they wouldn't. And especially the story that they had within the Lego movie was fantastic. It was actually, that's exactly what it is. It's an adult that, you know, this is what he wants to play with.
Very cool.
I think so.
Do you think that this movie will, like, the Cosmic Clash will also be kind of like maybe a gateway to like other kind of like, you know, DC?
I think so, because there's, you know, anybody can line this up with what's happening either within the current DC universe, or they can look back and we got to bring back a lot of kind of fringe characters within the Super Legion or Legion of Superheroes. So if you're a comic book fan, you're going to get to have some great fan service with a lot of the older storylines that we're actually bringing back and putting it into a new framework. Or if this is the first time for you to experience some of these storylines, it's a really cool way for you to kind of experience and know that it probably will not be as funny as it is in the movie.
So if people wanted to find out more about the project, find out more about you, social media, websites, all of that fun stuff, where would they go?
You can just Google.
Yeah, we all have
just Google it, guys.
In our phone.
Today actually is the first day that I've been back on Twitter in I think like 3 months. It took a little hiatus.
Why the break?
Our publicist is applauding that, which was cool. But you can definitely hit me up. It's at Troy Baker VA.
What could that VA possibly stand for, though?
Is Virginia. Like, I didn't know you from Virginia.
Yeah, Virginia. Like,
oh, that's cool. Troy Baker, VA on that. And, it's a cool way to kind of connect. I like having conversations with people.
I think that a lot of these human beings out in the audience.
A lot of humans.
Probably, yeah, they're okay sometimes. Would probably maybe, they probably look up to you because you've done something
amazing. I'm
very tall. You're also very successful with your voice. Could you give maybe people out there that would like to do voice acting maybe like a tip or a piece of advice on how to get into it? Because I hear it a lot.
Well, let's see it real quick. Who's got a show of hands? Who wants to actually be in this wacky, crazy business?
Who wants to do voices?
There we go.
I see hands. I see a lot of hands. Right here.
I know. I know.
All right. I like this dude right here because he had the lack of ego enough to not raise his hand, but his friends support you, so that's actually really important. Here's what I will say. Spend more time looking at the doors that are opening instead of trying to kick down the ones you want to open. Be open, because a lot of times your life chooses you. You don't necessarily choose your life. And don't worry about the voice. The voice is just a mechanic of it. Learn to be an actor. You're in a great city for theater. So if you're in New York, really get into theater and let that teach you how to put bones into a character and skin on a character. And when those doors open, be fearless. This is a job about making an idiot out of yourself. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to be an idiot, because that's what they pay you to do.
That's really well said.
Wisdom.
I have to admit, that was actually just a question for me.
Was it?
Yeah, I don't care if they want to be voice actors.
I want to be like your headshot and your resume and your demo reel.
Yeah, over to you. I have your address as well. I'll be knocking on your door.
So you probably get asked this often, like,
sure.
What's your favorite voice to actually do, besides your own normal voice?
I don't know. I mean, I will definitely say that being Lego Batman, growing up, that's the first graphic novel that I bought, so that's definitely one of the things that, you know, is a huge feather in my cap. And then inversely by that, playing the Joker was pretty awesome.
Yes, right.
That was a wonderful day for me.
That was so awesome, dude.
Yeah. Oh, beautiful. Well, Troy, thank you so much for taking the time to hang out here.
My pleasure.
Be at Comic-Con.
Sure.
Thank you, dude.
Of course.
All right, guys. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with some more Comic-Con. See you guys in just a moment.